my dear chess friends, and welcome to my channel. This is International Master Camilla Ciovanu, and today's lesson is about how to make good trades. And I'm going to show you a game that I have played in the year of 2004 at the Avoine Open in France. And I was having black against Philippe Vautrel, and we had a nice draw in the end. But I think this game is so nice, and we can learn a lot out of it. Okay, so we played a French, e4, e6, d4, d5, with a Tarrasch Variation, knight f6, and finally the push. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about this French. Well, my problem in this position is that bad bishop on c8, so I will have to find a way to trade that bishop. And let's see how this will be possible. Okay, so first of all, I eliminate the tension in the center, and thus white will have a weak pawn on d4. And finally, I have to develop my bishop because I will have to open up a path for it so that it will be possible to trade it, maybe for white's knight. Well, it would be ideal to be able to trade it for white's good bishop. If only that would be possible. Okay, so white is pushing the pawn forward because he wants to attack my pawn chain. Okay, and so I have to block his attempt by pushing the pawn up to f5. And he doesn't take en passant, but instead he pushes the pawn to a3. Well, why? Because maybe if he was to play something else, like knight to f3, in that case, I would like to go and attack the bishop. And of course, he wants to preserve it. It's the good bishop. And finally, I can open up my bishop, bring it to b5 and pin the knight, and so I will trade that bishop. For example, if the rook moves away, I will trade it for the knight. And so I have eliminated black's main problem in the French defense. Good. So he didn't play that, but instead he plays pawn to a3, anticipating that I wanted to bring my knight on b4, so he's trying to stop it. Well, in this case, I will push my pawn up to a5 because he has just weakened the b3 square. So I'd like to push my pawn forward and so create an outpost on b3. And after I push my pawn to a4, the knight can go to a5. And so I will be controlling white's weak squares, b3 and c4. Maybe one of my knights can land on one of those squares. Therefore, he will play pawn to b3. Because when I push a4 now, he is able to push pawn to b4, and I cannot take en passant because white brought the pawn on b4 in two steps. Okay, so what white accomplished is that he is controlling the a5 square, so I can't bring my knight in there. So I need to come up with another idea. But before focusing on trading that bishop, I will first of all castle. Okay, so I develop my bishop and I castle. And do you know why? Because I need the e8 square. Well, some of you might think that I would like to bring my bishop and develop it on the king side instead, and that could be an idea. I think it might be a good idea. But actually, I need the e8 square for the queen, and let's see why. Okay, so he's bringing the rook on the open file. Now I bring my knight on a7 because I want to bring the bishop to b5 and trade it for white's good bishop. So he will play knight to c3 to take the control of b5, not allowing my bishop to go there. And so I have to bring my queen so that now I have the third control over b5. So I will be able to bring my bishop in there. But guess what? He's bringing the queen too on e2. And so both of us are controlling that square three times. Okay, so I can't bring a piece there, not yet. So I will bring the rook to c8 to pin the knight on c3. Okay, and bishop to b2. And finally, now it is possible to bring the knight on b5 because in the end, the rook on c2 will be hanging. So let's see how. Knight to b5, even attacking the weak pawn on d4, right? threatening to take, and then that would be a double attack. It looks fine. So he trades my knight, and finally, first I take the rook, in this case. Okay, bishop takes c2. And finally, it was possible for me not only to bring my bishop on b5, but actually to trade it for white's good bishop. It's just that we are already in the end game, and so many of the pieces have been already traded. And I have an advantageous endgame because now I have the good bishop against white's bad bishop. Can you see that almost all white's pawns are on dark squares? Okay, so what I will do next, I will fix the structure on the queen side and gain even more control on c4, where I want to install my knight. So that's what I am going to do next, and I'm attacking the bishop. So I'm gaining not only a little bit more space, but even more initiative. And then I will have to focus on white's weakness on d4. So I'm bringing my bishop to b6. And I would like to bring my queen on a7, but I also have to pay attention because my pawn on b5 is a weak pawn. So what I have to do first is defend it properly, so then I can move my queen away. So how am I going to do that? With a very, very long travel with my king from one side of the board to the other. And what white does is just waiting. So he's just playing waiting moves. And finally, my king came to a6 to defend the weak pawn on b5. So my queen will be free to move. I could go to a7 and increase the pressure on d4. But he can defend that pawn very easily. So probably this was the moment in which I could have probably forced the position a little bit by pushing the pawn to g5, trying to break the pawn structure, because if he takes, I could take on e5 with my knight, okay? This would be good, so he shouldn't actually take on g5. So I could have tried to win by attacking the pawn on f4, but I played it very safely, and queen to a7, he defends the pawn. So basically white has two weaknesses. The one on d4 I can attack the most, but it's not sufficient. Even by repositioning my pieces, okay, I should create a second weakness. And actually what we do, we just agree for a draw at move number 46. So that was the clue moment in which I could have played g5 and try to play for a win by attempting to create a new weakness. And maybe this was the best strategy. So my dear friends, what a nice game, and I think it is very instructive on how to make good trades. Well, I have good memories of that tournament because I remember I won the first prize for the best lady in the tournament. So for that reason, it was even more pleasant. Thank you so much for your attention, and remember to download my chess application and to register so you can have direct access to all my videos. Here is International Master Camila Ciobanu again wishing you a most wonderful day. Talk to you next time.